and they still coming. Does this phrase sound familiar? This year, as of October 2023, over 730 people have made decisions for Christ across all of our campuses. Because souls are one of the only things that last forever, every time that we give through the Star Church, there is an eternal return on our investment. Your gifts have been and will continue to be used to bring more people to Jesus. Here's our ask. Pray about and consider a generous end of the year financial gift to God through the Star Church beyond your tithe. Business owners, pray about and consider giving a generous additional gift out of your corporate business. Believe God for the amount that He places in your heart. Obey God when He places the amount in your hand. Sunday, December the 3rd, 10 a.m. across all campuses, we're shooting for the stars.
November, December 2020. Matter of fact, I think you was doing a series on tithe at the time. I was brought up, you know, taught tithe, you know, get off in tithe. So I can't say it was something I learned. It was just something I wasn't doing. Like, I was just all hit. Like, I'm not doing, like, I'm gonna miss that money. And so I finally was like, you know what? I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna do it, like, whether I got it or not, I'm gonna do it. So boom, January hit, off to the races. And at the time, we were trying to buy a house. And so I don't know how I'm gonna pay off the credit card, pay off my car and still do all that. So boom, January hit, boom, pay off the car. So now it's like I'm tired and I'm seeing the blessings from it. I'm like, oh, this is it. You know, I'm at that point, I'm hyped. Like, boom, pay off credit cards. So April 1st, never forget. April Fool's Day of all days, apartment kind of catch on fire. So apartment catch on fire. And at the time, like, so Trey, Brandon, I'm texting them, like, look, like, my crib is, like, I'm watching it burn down. They thought it was a joke, because April Fool's Day, we lost everything. Like, it was gone. Like the roof closed. Like, in our actual room, you can tell we had no bed, no dressers, no TV, all the stuff was just, you know, down the ashes. You know, I'm a direct benefactor of, you know, you say all the time in church that, you know, you give through a church, not to a church. Because, you know, if it wasn't for, you know, the Star, you know, like I said, I don't know what it'd be. You call me a couple of days later. Yeah, you know, what y'all need, this, that, and the other. I'm like, everything at this point. We literally, because when we left the house originally, when the smoke happened, we probably had like one or two outfits because, like I said, we were planning on coming back to our crib once they got all the smoke out. So we ain't had no clothes, no drawers, no suit, no deodorant, or none of that stuff. Like, we got here back. And so, you know, I know if you told me, okay, I got you. And, you know, like, even when you, I look back at that, even when you said that, like, you hear about, you know what I'm saying, people that say do stuff like that, you'd be like, yeah, he didn't talk, you know what I'm saying? And so you called me, I was like, yeah, okay. And then you hit me back and was like, look, go by the church, teach them. And I was like, oh, wow. I'm like, no, are they see? Don't get me wrong, we were doing well before the fire, but it was like after the fire, it catapulted. You know, and you know, I tell you the tithe, you know, that type of stuff. And so, like last year, for example, like it made me feel good last year, like to know I had put up a little over $10,000 in church last year. And so, going from 2019, where I wasn't doing nothing, to like, and then also, not only that, my income. So, my income from 2019 to 2000, matter of fact, from 2021 to 2022, doubled. Just how God worked, went from bread to income doubling to buying a house. And not only that, we bought the house, but our mortgage and our rent was the same thing. I've gone through the fire.